say you're gonna burn before you mellow. I'll be the one to burn you. Why'd you have to go and pick?
We'd like to know what kind of music you listen to.
Actually, I'm a rocker by heart, but it ranges from Tori Amos to like industrial metal, stuff like that. But I like classic rock too, but I don't know, just like anything along there. But I do listen to like techno-y dance stuff. I don't know it by, like, you know, there's so many subgenres of dance music now. I can't identify them, but when I hear something I like, I'll be like, yeah.
Hip hop, R&B, I don't know, reggae.
Same.
I play some instruments and I collect CDs. I have almost 400 right now. I'm 23, so I don't know if that's a lot for my age.
I listen to alternative techno, electronica, ambient, everything.
Actually, my first CD was the Wayne's World soundtrack, and I got it when I was 13. So yeah, 10 years, 400. I don't know. Do the math.
Yeah.
Basically, where you live is what you're going to listen to, so.
Okay, we'd like to know if you think that Britney Spears is a bad influence on youth today.
Definitely, because she is showing her thong in like videos, and she's just the fact that I'm
totally
a slave for you
guard.
Doesn't like show any like female independence or like, you know, you don't need a man and you don't need to like, you can be your own. You don't have to like succumb to everything the guy says. Fuck men.
Yeah.
Sorry.
It's okay.
I think it's just inappropriate for young teens to have that sort of an example set for them. She does what she wants to do, and more power to her, you know? I think parents teach their children values, not pop stars.
I think she encourages girls to be stupid. Yeah, I think that she's ridiculous, and I heard a rumor that she's taking her parents' split really badly, and she's getting fat, and that somebody is suing her for a lot of money, and I hope that she becomes obese and bankrupt, and ends up living in a single-wide trailer because she can't afford a double-wide trailer. I think she encourages girls to be vacuous and vapid and not go to school, and to think that all they need to do is wear a midriff top and strut around the stage, and I think that pretty much any writer or intellectual of any sort, male or female, is a better role model for girls than Britney Spears.
She shows sort of a will to and a drive, you know, to succeed. And I actually enjoy the clothing she wears, and therefore other girls wear it. And it makes everybody a happy person.
She's getting like breast implants and like showing off everything, and little kids are looking up to her, so they see this and they're gonna wanna get breast implants, and they think that their bodies are like just for sex, so she has a bad influence.
I don't think she comes across as being very brainy or having something to say.
What do you think?
Who?
About Britney Spears?
Who's that?
We'd just like to know if you think that there should be an association to keep Britney Spears out of the music industry.
To keep who out of what?
To keep Britney Spears out of the music industry.
And why are we keeping her out of the music industry?
I don't know. We're asking you if you think that way.
I think everybody should be allowed to be in the music industry. I think everybody has music in them. And all we need to find is the right instrument to get it out.
Okay, we'd just like to know what your favorite color is.
Red.
Do you have any reason for liking it?
I don't know. I think it looks good on me.
Pink.
I love you. Okay, yeah, anyways.
Blue.
Do you have, like, any reason for liking pink?
Yes, it's happy.
See, these people are cool. And also, okay, if you're on a desert island, what three items would you take with you?
Paint, a lot of paint. Something to play CDs on, and CDs, can that be included? Like music, paint, and some friends.
Girl, car, a plane.
Well, I'd bring some Mary Jane, and I'd bring a lighter, and I'd bring a hot tub.
Is that it? Do you have anything else to add?
Maybe a beautiful woman.
That's four things.
I guess I could give up the hot tub.
Okay, desert island. I would, a woman, number one, a woman. Number two, I would take, a refrigerator full of an endless supply of cold beer, and I would take with me a connection to the internet, a laptop with wireless internet connection. Those are the three items I would take with me.
Ooh, sunscreen.
That's what you choose.
Shampoo.
What the hell? What end of the desert are you in?
Excuse me, I will find food on the desert.
And water?
Water, good call.
Good call. No, that's... Okay, not the shampoo, because, like, what the hell is that?
I don't
Sorry,
want to be dirty.
School. What else did I take? A little... I don't know.
Sunscreen
is good. Okay, we're going to stick with her answer.
Yeah.
My guitar, my skateboard, and a CD player.
My hockey stick, my hockey equipment, and a puck.
My guitar, that's all.
My stereo, my CDs, and Patrick.
Are you Patrick?
Okay, what's the items do you have?
A plane, a boat.
Some beads?
Some beads, yes, yeah, gotta have beads. Yeah.
Shit, what's our other question?
What do you prefer, skateboarding or inline skating?
You gotta skate. You gotta skate.
I suck at both, so I don't care. But I like watching skateboarding.
Inline skating.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you have any reason why?
Because I don't like to skateboard.
Okay.
Skateboarding.
Skateboarding.
Same.
Do any of you actually skate?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, I do.
Skateboarding. I'd say inline for me, I guess.
Board, I guess.
Well, it's just something that I like to do. I like to do art, and it's been around for years and years. It's a good way to find people who want to buy art, and I would imagine it's inspirational for the community as well.
Okay, so do you prefer Pepsi or Coke?
Pepsi.
I don't drink pop. I'm sorry.
Okay, how many?
Because it's had the better taste.
Darn straight, Pippa. Yeah, diet. Uh-huh, that's right.
Okay, well, this could be an urban legend, but I don't think so, because my sister doesn't make things up. She's an electrical engineer, and for their third year engineering project, some of the chemical engineers got together in electricals, and what they did is they took three rusted out engines, and they dripped salt water, regular water, and Coke, or should I say cola, sorry. Not to like slander anyone, but and they let it drip by drip on these like three rusted engines, and at the end of the year they found that the cola was the most corrosive, ate it right through.
She's making me do this. She has a gun to my back. Okay, I have a confession to make. I cannot tell the difference between Coca-Cola and Pepsi because I drink Diet Pepsi, and Diet Pepsi and regular Pepsi are very different. But yes, I admit it. Pippa, I cannot tell the difference between Pepsi and Coke. There, I said it. Yeah, so anyways, we're going to continue our little, like, let's talk to random people thing. Our new question is, how do you feel about the soccer thing? Are we doing that? Okay, let's not do that. Let's do, kind of dead here, so we're just going to ask people if they have anything to say.
No, not right now.
No.
No, I'm sorry, I can't think of anything just like that.
No, not really.
Not really, I'm just trying to see the city.
Not really.
Have a good day.
Thanks for your time. Where are you from?
Erie, Pennsylvania.
Oh, that's pretty cool. So how do you like Toronto so far?
Love it. Beautiful. Nice people.
We're here for a mental health conference.
Oh, where are you from?
Vancouver.
Oh, really? Why did you just come down here for vacation or? Like?
No, for business.
What's your business?
Wholesale.
Okay.
I'm from Montreal, so I'm just exploring the city now, trying to figure what it's all about. That's about it.
Okay, considering all of the styles that people are labeled with today, do you think that's right? Or do you think people just shouldn't assume things about other people by looking at them?
Styles, is this fashion?
It's right.
It's right. Yes, sexy styles right should. Here. Label us as
they
sexy.
They should label. That's because, girl, mm-hmm. sometimes I see some people, God, they should get, like, tickets from the police. You know what I'm saying? That's messed up. No, they should be labeled. And as a matter of fact, Queen Street, that's where you're going to find them. Can we say freaks? Okay. A lot of freaks. For example, girlfriend in the yellow, straight down there, red pants. So 80s. Okay, she has to go. What's that, purple? Is that a burgundy hat? Mm-hmm. Well, she's old, so she's entitled. But yes, we must label people. This way they should understand that fashion should be taken seriously.
I think it's horrible to label people by looking at them. You should get to know people and find out what they're all about. And clothes aren't so important. People should just wear what they like and do what they like.
Example. Blue. Can you get me, baby girl? Blue. You know what I'm saying? Blue. Work it. What can I say?
Well, I mean, everybody's got their own style and everybody makes judgments on people, but that's just human nature. But I don't know.
If you don't dress right, people talk. We do. Why think we're sitting here? We talk about everybody on everybody. That's my American thing. But yeah, it's important.
I guess in a certain way, because if you get dressed a certain way in the morning, you're trying to put out an expression to people. But not too much.
I think it's wrong. I just kind of think that you shouldn't really judge anyone on the way they dress, but sometimes people go out and they dress in a way where they're forcing people to judge them.
Okay, so people say that beauty is in the eye of the beholder. Do you believe that's true?
Yes, I would have to agree with that.
How about you?
Yes, definitely.
Do you have any reason why?
Because there's too many things that somebody might find beautiful that other people won't. So, it's proof right there.
Okay, some people say that beauty's in the eye of the beholder. Would you say that's true?
Yes.
Why?
Because I guess everybody likes something a little different.
Okay.
Well, I like this guy, and, you know, this is embarrassing. Let's go.
Okay, well, thank you.
Definitely. I definitely say that's true, because beauty is, not everyone has the same definition of beauty. Everybody, you know, some people think that, I don't know, a pile on the floor is beautiful as opposed to a person or a magazine or a model. So I'd say yes, but I think beauty is definitely an eye of the beholder.
It's an Indian instrument, actually, and I was introduced probably through the Beatles, which is a big influence. George Harrison, rest in peace. And he played this thing in the early 60s. He was kind of the first guy to bring Indian music into pop music. And so from listening to the Beatles, I got attracted to the sound of this, bought one, and then ever since I've just been playing it. Lessons and everything else.
She should just take a spin around and look at this. Just spin around and just take a shot of this whole area. Because when I first started coming down here, this place was all street kids doing windows and a much more friendly atmosphere down here. And then when you see places like Le Chateau and all these corporate places moving in down here, they've suddenly turned Queen Street West into the next Young Street.
Okay, hi. I see you here almost every weekend. And you're handing out these pamphlet things, and I think I have one of every color. Yeah. So, is this just part of working here, or is this actually your job?
This is pretty much the job. Yeah, I get to go upstairs every once in a while, but this is more exciting. I mean, it's Queen Street. It's like Halloween, right?
Yeah. How do you think the people that thought the world was going to end in 2000 feel now?
I think they feel pretty stupid. I mean, the world's still here. Maybe another couple million years before it's gone, so they must be just feeling pretty stupid now.
I've pretty much been drawing all my life, so it just seemed like a natural thing to do.
We drove this tractor from Saskatoon, Saskatchewan. We parked in front of Much Music because we're trying to get a farm tribute concert going. We're here to ask the people from Much Music if they'd be interested in helping us out, get some professional bands to come and play, sell some tickets, and raise some money.
Do you want to
Well, after we're going to Ottawa with our petition board here, and we're going to see if the government wants to support us in our concert and what we're trying to do. So,
Just that it was a long trip and we need people's help. So if anybody can help us out, you know, this is where we'll be.
I'm heading to Calgary right now to go protest the G8. I think the G8's wrong because it promotes world trade and it promotes third world countries being absolutely screwed over through slave labor and having their crops ripped out and having to go cash crops for first world countries. So basically, all free trade is it's the poor getting poorer and the rich getting richer, because it's the people on top making money. And then they go to these third world countries and they set up their sweatshops and everything, pay the people about $1 a day, because they know here they can't get away with that. So basically, I'm going to protest it because I believe it's wrong.
The only thing is, I've been out here 13 years. I'm a street kid, Irish punk, what can you say? But let the public actually, don't pity us, help us.
Yeah.
We're not scum, we're not evil.
There you go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you
very much.
Sorry.
No problem.
Like, help us out. Don't let us starve.
We're good kids, and that's why I started hanging out down here, because everyone here they're good people, you know? Everyone looks out for each other down here. It's not a bunch of, like, backstabbing bullshit like it is in the rest of the city.
And almost every kid that is out here has a reason. Mommy and daddy beat me. Girls, a lot of them are out here because daddy raped them. Or mommy raped them. And hey, that's the way it is. We're here because we have no choice. We can't get an apartment because we can't make enough to get an apartment. Without an apartment, we can't get a job. No one's going to take anybody with a shelter address. As simple as that. I've tried, and trust me, second they see a shelter address, forget it. They throw it aside into the garbage.
We're out here and all they give is fucking $200 every month. How the fuck is anyone supposed to live off $200, you know? Like, people with places get $500, but people who don't have a place get fucking $200, so they can't get themselves a place.
How do you feel about Toronto and the, like, so much homelessness going on around here?
I don't know, it doesn't really bother me. I mean, I think people make a decision to be homeless, live on the street. They get money, they can go to, like, food, banks and stuff, and it doesn't really bother me.
How do you feel about the constant, like, homelessness in Toronto?
It's sickening. I think that if everybody in this town got together and threw a dollar in, they could probably solve the problem. I'm really disappointed that everybody here isn't trying to do something about it.
I just feel everybody in the city's been really desensitized to the problems that they face. We drove a tractor down the 401 and barely got a look, so it's obvious that these people just, I don't know, obviously don't care anymore. Too self-centered, I guess. Too absorbed in their own lives to even care what's going on around them.
I don't know, I guess. I think that it's sad that all these people are sitting on the street, and lots of them don't have a choice or lost their chance or whatever, and people just walk by and they don't even look. And I feel really sorry for them. I told all of them if I had money on me, I'd give them all like $5, but I don't. So I don't know. Everybody, all of them have been really nice to us, and I can't see why people wouldn't give them a hand. It's like 5 cents, you know. I don't see why.
Yeah, a little from a lot goes a long way.
Yeah,
I mean, just want to know how you feel about the constant homelessness in Toronto.
It's an important problem, and I think the Ontario government has to do something about it, because there are 10,000 homeless youth on the streets of Toronto, and I think it's time that people give the damn and government housing and just help for these 10,000 people.
I recite my poetry for free, and I put it on display for free as well. I ask for suggested donations, but I don't require a donation. I still give away my typed works. And I'm just basically doing it to try to keep my supplies and also just make a little bit of money for food and other things that I need, because I don't really have a place at the moment.
I smoke marijuana. I am in full support of it. I'm sick and tired of fucking pigs bothering teenagers who smoke pot.
You're an idiot.
I am a stoner. And
okay, now put it down before, like, yeah, to everybody.
And pigs suck.
He's an idiot.
Yeah, I hate capitalism.
Is that it?
Yeah, because it's the root of all evil.
Why is this? Yeah, why do you think this?
Because it lacks benevolence and therefore has no mercy on anyone. So I think that kind of philosophy is wrong.
Yeah, stop saying the word can't. Can't is a bad word, people. Can't is a bad word. Spent 30 years saying I can't play guitar. And now?
Have a good life and have fun doing it.
Don't do drugs.
Rock out.
Stay at home, it's good for you guys.
Yeah. You mean like every day?
No. Like stay living at home, don't run away or anything. Don't be stupid like me.
Like you guys run away from home?
Yeah, I live in Edmonton, Alberta, and I like hitchhiked here. So don't do it, it's stupid.
I should have thought of that before.